This is what I made in 2020 when it was still DaVinci Resolve 16, and I just remember this week, I think it was, yeah. And I thought, well, why don't I just make a video sharing those to the world, right? Well, in this video, this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna share with you these transitions. Now, they're not gonna be as advanced as the new transitions that I have, meaning that you're not gonna be able to go into the inspector and actually adjust settings and customize it much. Basically, it's using the old method, which consists in using adjustment layers, because back then that's all we had, so we had to adapt, right? So when you download these, what you're gonna get is a folder like this, well, basically a zip file, right? After that, you're gonna open this project, and DaVinci Resolve 17 or 18, whichever you're working on, is gonna import this project as a new project. So once the project opens, this is what you're gonna have. It's gonna say Theta Transitions, and you're gonna have the sound effects, which are a couple of sound effects that I created back then too, I guess. Then there's method 2 and method 1. Method 2 is basically unusable. Well, you can still use it, but you're not gonna be able to see the previews here because for some reason I can't find the files anymore. Maybe I deleted them. So if you drag this one on, you are gonna have to decompose this in place, and now you have the actual adjustment layer, but you cannot see the preview one on this method, right? Now, the method that I would say you would want to use is method 1. Why? Because here you can actually see the previews. Let's see a shake transition, and you have the different previews right here. Now, by default, it's probably gonna look like the other one that I just showed you. Basically, it's gonna show up media, or like it's gonna prompt you to relink the media, right? What you want to do is you're gonna right click, and you're gonna go towards it, relink selected clips. After that opens, you're gonna go to that same folder where you downloaded and extracted all those files, and you're gonna have to find these preview files and then go to Theta Visuals, and you'll see them here. So by default, this one is already open in this viewer. So I'm just gonna select this folder, and that's gonna relink everything basically. Okay, let me just show you. To preview these, all you wanna do is just press play, and now you can see how the transition works. And I think I managed to make it completely so that they are organized if you have them like this. So basically they're going to be side by side. The preview is going to be on the right and the actual transition on the left, and it's going to be an adjustment layer that you just drag onto your timeline, and now you're set. There it goes. Now, one thing, if you want to edit these, all you have to do is go into Fusion and you can play around with these and see how they were made, how they work, and basically play around with it, right? Now, what if you want to reuse these on different projects? It's not that complicated, and the cool thing is that method 1 is actually the one that works for these two, because for method 2, which since it has compound clips, which were originally designed so that you could preview these more easily, right? You're not able to put these into the master or the power bins here. So if you want to open these in other projects, all you got to do is grab this Theta method 1, drag these into your power bins, and now from here you can just drag these into another project. Now, what you would probably do is go and find it here and then just drag the transition here. Now, what this does is that when you drag this transition, let's say this one for example, into a new project, the master bin is gonna bring that adjustment layer here, and it's gonna look a little bit not organized after a while of you dragging different transitions if you use a couple of different ones. So what I would recommend that you do is grab these, put them in the power bins first, and after that, when you open a new project, all you gotta do is bring this Theta method 1 and put this into your master bin for your projects. That way you can just go back in and then find the actual transitions here and just drag them from here without them creating a new replica of the adjustment layer. Now, if you want to download these, I didn't create an email signup form for these because the file weighs a little bit over 350 megabytes, and that would have made it pretty difficult for me to deliver because of the servers and all that stuff. So I created a Flurly page that you can just go and find in the link in the description, and all you gotta do there is press download a sample, and then you can download these for free. And if you want to drop like a coffee or something, you can just also do the pay as you want option, but either way, no pressure, just download it for free. I just wanted to share this one with you all, but if you want, you can actually grab a few of the paid packs that I have on the SUALVI website. That is it for this video. I hope you find it helpful, and I'll see you in the next one. Here's SUALVI. Bye.